Good afternoon, as we go to where China's foreign minister has just met with Prime Minister Anthony Albanese. Let's go live to politics reporter Claudia Vidoljak. Claudia, what's been discussed?
Well, Minister Wang Yi has just met with Anthony Albanese and Foreign Minister Penny Wong, shaking hands for the cameras before entering a closed-door discussion not long ago. This is the first meeting with our PM in Australia. Earlier today, both foreign ministers met, and while they exchanged smiles and handshakes outside behind closed doors, frank views were shared. Penny Wong sat down with China's foreign minister to discuss a number of issues, including the suspended death sentence of Australian writer Dr. Yang Hengjun, reiterating that the Australian government will continue advocating for him, also raising concerns about human rights violations and the desire for peace across the Taiwan Strait. Minister Wang is the most powerful Chinese politician to visit Australia since 2017. Today they discussed the importance of continuing that dialogue with confirmation there will be more regular meetings between Chinese and Australian leaders.
Australia will continue to be Australia. China will continue to be China. We are bound by geography, by history, by our peoples, by our trade. We know that there are differences that arise out of who we are, and we want to manage them wisely.
One of those differences hoped to be resolved soon, China's harsh tariffs on Australian wine. While Minister Wong isn't saying cheers just yet, she has welcomed the progress on the removal of trade restrictions. In a promising sign, Minister Wong and his entourage stopped into a local winery near Canberra last night. While he didn't take Australian media questions today, he did give Nine News a hint of what's to come.
Good morning.
Will you have good news for Australia today?
Oh, lots of good news.
But the foreign minister's visit was not good news for Tibetan activists who clashed with police outside the Chinese embassy this afternoon, Kate.
Claudia Vidoljak in Parliament House, thank you. A fiery day in state parliament with pro-Palestinian protesters disrupting proceedings. As Eddie Meyer reports, it wasn't the only disruption our politicians faced.
It was just 25 minutes into an already robust question time when a small group of protesters made their voices heard. This outburst over the ongoing war in Gaza. MPs could be seen looking up into the public gallery. Sound was cut as parliamentary staff and sheriffs rushed to eject those yelling out and holding banners. A short time later, question time was shut down, and again around half an hour later when another protester called the Premier a disgrace.
Christmas, you are a disgrace.
I understand people have got frustrations. I think that it should be noted that disrupting question time and parliamentary democracy is not something that we can endorse.
It wasn't the only protest today. Hundreds of firefighters marched on Parliament while those in trucks blew their sirens and honked their horns, which could all be heard inside the question time chamber. As to what their gripe is with the government, well, I'll have those details. Nine News at 6.
Police have renewed their search for the body of missing mother Samantha Murphy, converging on bushland at Buninyong, south of Ballarat, 2 weeks after 22-year-old Patrick Stevenson was charged with her murder. Gillian Lantouris joins us from the search site. Gillian, what prompted police to act now?
Kate, police say intelligence from multiple sources has prompted this renewed search in the Buninyong bushland, which is about 15 kilometres away from where missing mum Samantha Murphy was last seen. Of course, she went out for a jog in early February and never returned. Now, after 8 hours of trekking through this thick bushland, both on horseback and on foot, police have concluded their search for her, and sadly, there is still no sign of the mother of three. This comes 2 weeks after Patrick Stevenson, a 22-year-old man, a son of a former AFL footballer, Oren Stevenson, he was charged with one count of murder. And now he was arrested in the suburb over, so quite close to this search site, but it's understood he has remained tight-lipped. He's not giving police any indication of where her body is, so it's not him who has prompted this search here. Police are holding out hope, but the most important person, Mick Murphy, her husband, is really hoping that she is found. There will be more searches in the coming weeks, Kate, as police gather more intelligence.
Yeah, hopefully her family gets some answers soon. Gillian Lantouris, thank you. There are dire warnings out of Gaza about widespread famine developing in the Strip's north between now and May. The UN saying the impending catastrophe is entirely human-made.
This is the highest number of people facing catastrophic hunger ever recorded by the Integrated Food Security Classification System anywhere, anytime.
US Secretary of State Anthony Blinken says Gaza's 2.2 million people are experiencing severe levels of acute food insecurity. A hearing is underway into the Biden administration's withdrawal of US troops from Afghanistan in 2021. The top two US generals who oversaw the evacuation have told Congress the Biden administration did not adequately plan for the evacuation. General Mark Milley said he had recommended 2,500 troops remain on the ground to maintain stability in the final days of the war. Brazil's former president and COVID skeptic Jair Bolsonaro is defiant despite being indicted for suspected vaccine fraud. It's alleged he inserted false information into the health ministry's database to make it look like he'd been vaccinated shortly before he visited the US in December 2022. Bolsonaro has said, "The world knows I didn't take the vaccine." From today, those on the age pension and Jobseeker will see a modest bump in their fortnightly payments. For those looking for a job, it equates to an extra 96 cents a day, which advocates say is nowhere near enough. For more, let's bring in former truck driver Cliff Fraser, who is on Jobseeker payments. Cliff, how hard is it to make ends meet on roughly $700 a fortnight?
That is very difficult. We have to plan our trips, and we go into town, we have to go in and, you know, make a list, a shopping list, if you like, or a to-do list, and try and get everything done so it's all done in the one lot of fuel.
So what are you and others in your situation going without in order to get by?
My wife and I were discussing this yesterday, and we tend to have most of our meat meals minced meat, and the rest the cheapest cuts possible. And my wife has got very, very good at buying the cheapest product that will do the job.
Well, we know so many people are doing it tough at the moment. How much of an impact will 96 cents extra a day have on your weekly budget?
Look, you know, $14 a fortnight, that's a pittance. That's almost an insult. That means nothing. That's probably not even bringing us up to a cost of living.
Do you think it has been harder at the moment because of the cost of living?
Yes. The price of everything has gone up. We're a bit fortunate. We live in a caravan on our daughter and son-in-law's property, so we don't have to pay rent. But people that we know, the rent has gone up significantly in the last 12 months, and we've managed to avoid that. So we're a little bit better off because of that.
Cliff, what do you think the federal government should be doing to help those who fall on tough times?
We should be bringing the Centrelink rates up to at least the same as the pension rates, and possibly more than that, so that we can actually live a healthy and effective life.
Well, Cliff, we really appreciate you joining us today. Thank you so much for your insight.
Thank you very much, Kate.